Hello students, welcome to sentence and classes. We are working from home. Hope you are doing study well at your homes and doing assignments all the times. So now students, please, in the exercise miscellaneous of chapter 2, then question number 5 is related to the modulus function. So first of all, we have to be clarity about the what is modulus function. So I know you all are be aware about this symbol, this known as modulus. So in 10th, you must have across the terms, like if there is minus 6 inside the mode. So we said that whatever number inside is the mod, we will get only a positive term. So mod minus 6 would be 6. So do you know what is the reason behind it? That whenever we put a negative number inside a mod, it converts into 6. What is the mechanism behind it? So let's see. Okay. So fx is equal to mod x. So what is the actual definition of modulus function? We'll look at. So fx would be, if f is equal to mod x, then mod function says that if x inside the box is less than 0, it means what? If x is negative, then mod put additional negative before the x, okay? And if x is greater than and equal to 0, it means what? Positive, then mod just simply give the value inside the x. So now we'll look at some examples. Suppose x is minus 6, x is plus 6 and x is minus 6. Okay, now you have to find the value of mod x over here in this case as well, and mod x in this case as well. Okay, so now I'm finding the here value. So x is plus 6. So 6 is greater than 0, less than 0. 6 is greater than 0. Then mod will give us simply the x. So it means what? Answer would be 6. Now come to this part. Here x is minus 6. So here minus 6 is less than 0, greater than 0. Minus 6 is less than 0. So mod would put an additional negative in front of the number. So additional negative, then x. And x is what? Minus 6. So then this minus minus would be plus. It means what? 6. So that's the reason behind the logic, that why mod gives us positive number, whatever quantity we put inside. So whenever there is a negative number, mod will put an additional negative. So negative negative would be positive. Now we will look at the graph of this function. This is our x axis, y axis, negative x axis and negative y axis and origin. When x is 0, then y would be mod 0, it means what? 0. X 0, y 0. When x equals to 1, y would be mod 1, it means plus 1. When x is 1, then y is also 1. When x is 2, y would be mod 2, it means what? Positive 2. When x is 2, y is also 2. See, so that would be the pattern of the function for this reason. When x is minus 1, then y would be minus 1, and modulus give always positive number. So when x is minus 1, y would be positive 1. When x is equal to minus 2, y would be minus 2 equals to positive 2. When x is equal to minus 2, y would be, so that would be the nature of the function, this side. That is the graph of fx is equal to mod x. Now, what would be the domain of this function? Domain is all the value of x which defined at which function is defined. So I can take all negative numbers over here, I can take 0 as well, and I can take all the positive numbers. It means what? Domain of the function would be entire real number. Now talk about the rest of the range. So range is, am I getting any negative value of y? Here x positive, y positive, x positive, y positive, y positive. Here x negative, y positive, x negative, y positive. I am not getting any negative value of y. It means what? The range would be all real positive number plus 0. So that would be the range. Now please pause the video and note it down. Students, now look at the question number 5 of chapter 2 miscellaneous exercise. Find the domain and the range of the real function f x equals to mod x minus 1. So I will solve it by two methods. Now it's all up to you which method you find most suitable. Okay, so now first of all I am solving graphically. Okay, so fx equals to mod x minus 1. So here draw the graph. X axis, y axis, minus x axis and minus x axis. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So when x equals to 0, then y, it means fx. Fx and y are same thing. Y equals to 0 minus 1, it means what? Mod minus 1, it means what? 1. So when x is 0, y equals to 1. Okay, this is first point. When x equals to 1, then y would be 1 minus 1 equals to what? 0. So when x equals to 1, y is 0. It means this would be the point. When x equals to 2, y would be mod 2 minus 1, it means what? Mod 1, it means what? Plus 1. So when x is 2, y equals to 1. When x equals to 3, y would be 3 minus 1, it means what? 2. When x is 3, then y is 2. This point. So here, the graph would go like that. Okay. Now, when x equals to minus 1, then y would be minus 1 minus 1. It means what? Minus 2, it means what? Plus 2. So when x is minus 1, okay, y would be plus 2. That would be the point. Okay, when at minus 1, value is minus 2. When x equals to minus 2, then y would be minus 2 minus 1. It means what? Minus 3. It means what? Plus 3. When x is minus 2, value is minus 3. So here, the graph would go like that. Okay, so this is a graph of y equals to mod x minus 1. And what was the graph of y equal to mod x? That was this. So we can see over here, when graph was y equals to mod x, then the tilt was at 0. When graph is x minus 1, then tilt shifted to the 1 point further. If it would be x minus 2, then the graph would be like 2. This is the point 2, then graph would be like that. So here, by this, you can draw the graph of mod function very easily. Now, back to the question. So here, domain of the function would be C graphically. Okay. So I can take number greater than 1. I can take x less than 1. So the domain of the function is whole real number. So it means domain what? Real number. Now look at the range. So range would be y is 0, y is plus 1, plus 2, plus infinite, but there is no negative y. It means what? Range is r positive plus 0, or we could say 0 to infinite. Same thing, 0 to open interval infinite. Answer. This was the first method. And second method, please note it down. Okay, now I will solve it by the second method. Now we will solve it by the as per the definition. So we know that if fx equals to mod x, then if the number inside the mod would be negative, would be less than 0, then there would be value of this would be minus x. And if the number inside the mod is positive, then value would be x. So now here fx equals to, we have inside the mod x minus 1. So when x minus 1 is less than 0, so mod will put an additional negative, so that would be minus x minus 1. If x minus 1 is less than 0, and if x minus 1 is greater than or equals to 0, then that value would be x minus 1. So I can write like that, fx would be, that would be minus minus plus 1 and minus x. So I can write it like 1 minus x if x is less than 1, okay, and that would be x minus 1 if x is greater than or equal to 1. Okay, so now clearly domain, I can see that here the value of x are less than, this is our 1, less than 1, all value less than 1, it means what? Infinite to 1, okay, and every value equals to 1 and greater than 1. This is my negative infinite and this is positive infinite. So it means what? Technically I am taking all the value of x as a real number. So domain would be real number. Okay, now for the range, for both definition, whether it is 1 minus x, y equals to 1 minus x, or y equals to x minus 1. Least value of the function would be when x equals to 1, y could be 0, because it cannot be negative. So least value is 0. This here as well, when x equals to 1, y would be 0. So one thing is very sure, that the range will start from 0. And how up this can go? Because x is real number. I can take any x. It means what? I can take any x from the real number. So the range would be go to the positive infinite. So it's all up to whether you choose the graphical method or this method. Okay. Now please pause the video and note it down. Now look at the question number 6, which is f equals to x comma x square upon 1 plus x square, where domain is real number. Find the range of f. So it's nothing, actually it is fx equals to x square upon 1 plus x square. So it was given in the ordered pair form. So it's like f equals to x square upon 1 plus x square, meaning that image of x is x square upon 1 plus x square. So now we have to find the range of this function. So beta, for every x belong to real number, x square will always be greater than or equal to 0, and obviously 1 plus x square will also be greater than or equal to 0. So it means what beta? Ki jo function fx would be, that is x square upon 1 plus x square, would always be greater than or equal to 0. Consider it as equation number first. Okay, now x square will always be less than 2x square plus 1. Whatever x is there, so this value would always be less than x square plus 1. So I'm dividing both sides by x square plus 1. So it would be what? That this is less than 1. Consider as equation number second. It means what? Your fx equals to x square upon x plus 1 less than 1. So now observe the equation first and second. In this equation, I am saying that fx is greater than and equal to 0. This is 0. I am saying that value of fx is equals to 0 and greater than 0. Okay. And in the second equation, I am saying that fx is less than 1. So suppose if it is my 1, then second equation is saying that fx is less than 1. Okay. So what would be the common point of all these two equations? That would be that my function is bounded between 0 to 1. I am repeating again, as per the equation first, the function is equals to 0 and greater than 0. As per the second equation, function is less than 1. So what would be the common solution of both the equations? That value of function lies between 0 to 1. So from equation first and second, range would be equals to 0 to 1. At 1 we will use the open interval, because here the inequality is only less than, not equals to. So that would be the range of the function. So please pause the video and note it down.